I think I found the one. I've seen advertisements for this weapon for what feels like ages now, but I just didn't want to switch away from my dually squelchers. How could anything top being able to paint and track at the same time, right? But hear me out, hear me out. What if you didn't have to track opponents at all? Because they can't move. Oh my god, I'm having so much fun! Please excuse the caps. In fact, I'm even changing my username for the occasion. I officially love Toxic Mist. Sincerely, Mist Squid. Can I give something more than 5 stars?
Title on this one is pretty accurate. Depending on the match, man, I swear it's random. Someone's feeling pretty grim at the end. Usually it's me.
Have you ever wanted to make it clear to all the other Inklings around you that you had really good friends? Because, man, when our whole squad rolls up into League, I feel so connected to my friends. Even if we sometimes lose 5 matches in a row. Or 6. Or 7. Okay, you get the point. It's also good for pretending you have friends when they won't add you back. I don't understand why Judd just won't let me wear shoes at the same time when I want to wear this, though. I promise I won't take advantage of the extra abilities. Probably.
Hey gang, Miss Squid back. Tried a short-range weapon with the same type of setup, the old Mistin. And you know what? I don't know why, but this one just doesn't feel the same. I mean, hear me out. It's great to slow people down, but I have to go so far into the mist to get people after I miss them. Tragic. They had a good idea with the rain, I guess. Maybe I should design a weapon with mist launcher instead of bomb launcher. I bet it would sell out instantly. Hire me, please? Please? Or maybe I should take this idea to V-Bay. I'm returning these ones. 2 stars.
Did you know this vest doesn't let you float? I walked all the way to Mahi Mahi Resort with this thing on, just to find out I still couldn't go in the pool. 1 star.
Oh my god, he's perfect in every way. The tentacles wibble and wobble all over the place so realistically, you'd think you actually captured a jellyfish from the square and brought it right back to your apartment. Not that I'm ever thinking about that. Not in the slightest. 5 stars. Good. Good.
Miss Squid again. Tried a weapon without mist. Thought, hey, maybe a burst bomb would feel like toxic mist because you aim it directly at squids and it instantly explodes. Right? Wrong. It's not fun at all. Where's the joy in seeing your enemies get stuck if they just get pelted with your ink and then are able to walk away like nothing happens? Love the direct shots, though. Too bad I can't aim too well. And maybe it's because I aim at opponents stuck in toxic mist all the time. 4 stars.
So today I learned why this hat is so cheap. You're paying for it afterwards, in the supplies that you need to make it good. Do you know how many of my sea snails and coins I had to use to fix this hat? Good lord, do you know how hard it is to find sea snails these days? Ever since Pearl and Marina retired from hosting Splatfests, they've just been getting rarer and rarer and... Hopefully, it's good enough in battle to make up for my losses. Please, just say Takanoka to this hat if you ever see it on the market, because, wow, do I feel bad about this purchase. I don't know, I kinda thought that it would already have the slots filled out or something if I was buying it secondhand, but... Here we are!
I can't believe I just spent my life savings on a gold-plated toothpick, only to find out it has special charge?
I mean, come on! Couldn't it have last-ditch effort or something rare?
Okay, Miss Squid back just one more time. But not to actually use this weapon, no. It doesn't have mist, after all. I realize that these bad boys have toothbrushes at the ends of the handles. How amazing is that? Well, I bought a spare clean pair to use for my own hygiene, and let me tell you that these are unnecessarily good. Do you ever think about how many toothbrushes are being wasted every day on the battlefield? Do you? Because I sure didn't before now, and now that's all I'm thinking about. Please help. The humble, dear, sweet Splattershot Jr. Yes. Some of us do break our weapons and need a replacement. Yes. Some of us cherish our Splattershot Jr. even after all of these years of splatting, ranking up, and moving on to other weapons. Just because, you know? Because who are you, if not for where you began your journey all those years ago in the plaza? A junior in your hands, broke, and probably bad at turf war. Don't you ever want to relive those days? Don't you ever want to throw a bomb and miss by miles, only to watch it skitter away from you and your opponent, giving away your position and getting you splatted almost immediately after? Don't you live for the rush of adrenaline of a super close turf war, one where you don't even know who won until those cats descend from what felt like the heavens to give you a verdict you would have never guessed on your own, that you somehow won that long, grueling match that was in reality just a 3-minute battle? Sometimes we get so used to what we've been doing all these years that we forget our roots, where we've come from. Also, the weapon is just fun. Have you ever seen something on the internet and thought it was too good to be true? Well, today I found that out pretty quickly. Saw a CD on sale. Thought to myself, were Off the Hook even a thing 5 years ago? That answer was no. But what did I do? I bought the dang CD anyway. Now if only there were returns. None of those. Guess I'm keeping this. Alright.